You got several videos on YouTube, maybe 400 or 500 clips, man. You know what I'm saying? Got the whole world on YouTube, though. YouTube. Brothers throughout the country that's out in the streets. It's a world, man. Check it out. A whole new world. We're in Galatians, the second chapter. Walk through this, all right? Walk straight through. Galatians, the second chapter. Picking it up. Fifth verse. I want you to give Galatians the third chapter from the top. That's what it's all about. It's about this Bible. It's about the Word. It's a little busy out here than usual, and rightfully so. Thank you, Kelly. We praise the Lord about it. It's going to be hot during the summertime, and this Word is going to be right in the thick of it. Right in the thick of it, man. Nobody gonna be able to get out of here telling this word. Tell them what you got, huh?
Galatians 2:5.
Right.
To whom we gave place by subjection. No, not for an hour. That the truth of the gospel might continue with you.
Like the truth of the gospel is supposed to continue with the Israelites. The truth of the gospel is supposed to continue with Israel. And we gave place. That's what the Paul is saying. How you doing? We gave place to them so that they can come through with what cats kept being under corrupted and unaware. Guys that are against the gospel and truth. Show what you got out.
Galatians 2:6.
Yes.
But of these who seem to be somewhat, whatsoever they were, it maketh no matter to me.
Right.
The Most High accepteth no man's person.
Right.
But they who seem to be somewhat in conference added nothing to me.
That's the whole thing about it, man. We meet brothers and sisters and things, and they like the way we preach in our setup. And we appreciate that. But it's of no profit to us. But you don't keep with it. You understand? It's no problem. You know, it don't mean nothing to us. I mean, you know, we're not celebrities. We're not looking for people to clap and spend money and pay us or whatever the case may be. How you doing? This is about salvation, about deliverance in the Spirit of Christ. Come on now.
Galatians 2:7.
Yes.
But contrarywise, when they saw that the gospel of the uncircumcision was committed unto me,
right,
as the gospel of the circumcision was unto Peter.
Right.
For he that walketh.
Stop. That's the seventh foot. Here now.
Yeah.
How you doing?
Thank
all right.
You.
Give me a Acts 9. I want you to have all these precepts on this. I'm going to start to put the other Galatians. Give me Acts 9:16. Acts
13:46-48.
Galatians 3:1, right? Galatians 3:1. What foolish Galatians? That you should not obey the truth. That you should not obey the truth. Oh, foolish Galatians. The thing is, how can you be so foolish to go directly against the truth and believe in a lie? That's the question. That's the wonder. That's the astonishment. You understand? Read on out. Galatians 3:1. You can see it plainly in front of you what these things are, but yet you go for the thing that's wrong or false or that's a lie.
Read it. Well, foolish Galatians, who have bewitched you that you should not obey the truth?
Right. Who have bewitched you that you should not obey the truth? Who told you that it's all right not to obey the truth? Who told you that it's lawful to be wicked? How could that be, read on that?
That you should not obey the truth,
right?
Before whose eyes Jehoshaphat Christ has been evidently set forth, crucified among you.
Right, before whose eyes Christ was crucified among you. Check this out. Like Paul said, the gospel of the circumcision was committed to Peter, as well as the gospel of the uncircumcision was committed to him. So what you got, Acts 9:10?
Acts 9:10.
Yes.
And there was a certain disciple at Damascus named Ananias.
Right.
And to him said the Lord in a vision, Ananias. And he said, Behold, I am he, Lord. I am here, Lord. And the Lord said unto him, Arise, and go into the street, which is called Straight.
Right.
And inquire in the house of Judas.
Right.
The one called Saul of Tarsus.
Right.
And behold, he prayed.
Right.
And have seen in a vision a man named Ananias coming in and putting his hand on him that he might receive his sight.
Check. That's how the Lord is making the play here. He gave Saul a vision. He gave Paul a vision to go to the church and pray. At the same time, he told Ananias to come and pray for him. Come and set this brother Saul up. Direct him to where I need him to go. You know that.
Acts 9:13.
Right.
Then king.
Brother, see, that's brother come running by with your woman and the baby. The wind is fierce out here, and he got this little unprotected carriage, and the wind is smacking the baby in the face, and the baby's crying. Bad. The brother don't have wisdom enough to tell his sister to pick up. He don't pick up the baby himself and protect the baby from the wind. Push the empty carriage. We know that.
Acts 9:13. Yeah? Then Ananias answered, Lord, I have heard by many of this man how much evil he hath done to thy saints at Jerusalem.
God, how much evil this brother here, Saul, hath done to the saints at Jerusalem.
And here he hath authority from the chief preacher to bind all that call on thy name.
Right, to bind up everybody that call on the name of Christ. Read it, brother.
But the Lord said unto him, go thy way, for he is a chosen vessel unto me,
right,
to bear my name before the Gentiles and kings and the children of Israel.
Before the Gentiles, or in other words, the nations. Before the Gentiles, in other words, the nations. Before kings and before the children of Israel. Three different peoples. Three different classifications. The Gentiles being all the other nations, or the heathen, the Gentiles, the kings of the earth, wherever they may be, and the Israelites, the whole 10 tribes, 12 tribes of them. Only the 12 tribes of Israel. Read on out.
Acts 9:16. Well, show them how great they are. Ananias went his way, entered into the house, and putting his hands on him, said, brother, Lord, appear unto thee in the way as thou camest, and have sent me that thou mightest receive thy sight to be filled with the Holy Spirit.
That's how it goes. So now here it is now. Brother Kenny, a couple weeks ago, he said, man, he don't believe nothing that Paul wrote. He said he don't believe nothing that Paul wrote. He said he's a six-day man. He believed in the sixth day of the creation. Most I created man on the sixth day. And he said, Adam is another man, a different man, created on the seventh day. He said, Adam's a white man. Flip it. Rugged.